Hi everyone, it's Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about sound absorption technologies and positioning them in the room. But before we do that, we're going to talk a little bit about air movement and pressure inside our room so you can kind of understand why a lot of the products in the marketplace today work the way they're designed to work, but most do not. Most are not placed in the proper spots within your room to realize a full absorption potential. There's a lot of misleading claims, so I think a little bit of science about sound velocity and pressure will help us here. So let's take a sound source inside of our room and we'll call it a speaker. So from that speaker, energy radiates and it has a certain velocity or speed. Okay, and we all know that sound travels at a roughly 1130 feet per second. So when that sound energy strikes the wall, it produces pressure, okay, at the room boundary surfaces. And that pressure varies with the distance from the wall. So we have velocity or speed of the sound while it's in the room space, but then when it strikes a boundary, it creates pressure zones radiating out from that boundary surfaces. Obviously, the closest the sound is to the boundary, the higher the pressure, okay? So at the area of the wall, at the surface, room surface boundary, we have the highest pressure, but the lowest velocity or speed because the sound basically is like a car, it's crashed into the wall. So as it was moving through the room, it had maximum velocity or speed, but when it hit the wall, it created a maximum pressure and it was no longer moving, so it had no speed. Most of the sound absorbing technologies in the marketplace that call themselves low frequency absorbers need to be influenced by the velocity or the speed of the sound, not the pressure. So you can see our areas of pressure are all along the room boundary surfaces. So when you take these devices and you place them in the room boundary surfaces, that is the area of least velocity or less speed and greater pressure. Well, these devices that claim to be low frequency absorbers are really middle and high frequency absorbers. And we've discussed the mislabeling of products in our no such thing as bass traps videos and things like that. But manufacturers that hang their units on the wall that are really middle and high frequency absorbers need velocity or air movement in order to achieve their performance results. Positioning a middle and high frequency absorber on the wall and call it a bass absorber, which has to work with pressure, is very misleading. And I think you can see by our illustration here that bass absorbers, resonant absorbers, Helmholtz resonators, low frequency absorbers that really work need to work on pressure, not velocity. Velocity is for the middle and high frequency absorbers. So anybody that says, well, our bass absorber works best in a corner and it's not a resonant or a Helmholtz resonator, that's misleading. So you have to be aware of how the science works behind the absorption technology. Air movement or velocity is for middle and high frequency absorption, porous absorbers, absorbers that need air movement going through them. Pressure along room boundary surfaces is for your Helmholtz and your resonating absorbers, which is a special design technology that works on pressure. So the design parameters of the technology are designed to work on sound pressure, not sound velocity. Thank you.